this video, I'm going to share with you the 7 biggest mistakes that I've identified that business owners make. Hey guys, I'm James Sinclair. I'm a business owner here in the UK. I employ over 400 people. We do millions of pounds worth of sales each year over a different variety of businesses. This is where I'm coming from to help grow your business. So if you like entrepreneurial videos and you like marketing videos, you like business stuff, you've come to the right place. Make sure you hit subscribe and the notification bell so we can notify you when we bring out great new content to help grow your business. So guys, welcome back. So look at the biggest mistakes that business owners make. And this is really interesting because while we're doing this, we've set up a Facebook Live and I've actually had business owners share with us their biggest frustrations and mistakes that they've made in their business so that you can avoid making them too. And then I'm going to fill in the content. Let's have a look at point number one. Overtrading is one of the big things that business owners do. My God, I've been guilty of it. What is overtrading? Well, this is where you trade the business more than it can actually do. So you buy in too much stock, or you open a second or a third site, or you employ people before you've already got the sales in, or you're selling too much and the business can't cope with all the sales. They're all examples of overtrading. Most entrepreneurs overtrade because they've got the entrepreneurial DNA and they're growing the business faster than they can, you know, they're running before they can walk. How can you overtrade with success? Well, you've got to make sure you're properly funded. You've got to make sure you've got a great management team around you so that you can protect yourself when you're overtrading. Most businesses are not funded properly and therefore they overtrade, and it's a big reason why they go bust. Here's some facts about businesses, and this is something you might want to take to heart. 50% of businesses are gone within 2 years, 80% are gone within 5 years, 94% are gone within 10 years. That means only 6% of businesses that start up get through 10 years. And overtrading is a big reason why they don't get to where they want to get to. They've got this really successful business, they're turning loads of money, but they are overtrading the business. Watch out for overtrading, guys. Make sure that you've got them cash buffers around you. Make sure your business has as little cost as possible, because that's how you can fight through those dangerous times. Let's look at point number two, lack of management. This is the big thing that I've learned as an entrepreneur. My sort of golden success rule for entrepreneurship is E plus M equals S. That's entrepreneurship plus management equals success. When I've worked with my clients in businesses, growing their businesses, or I've looked at our weaknesses in our businesses, and the biggest mistakes that we've made is we've either stretched the management or haven't had the good quality management, or there's too much entrepreneurship in the business and not enough management. Management is the key to success, because the management in a business is going to make sure the stuff's happened. It's making sure the details put in place. And I've always sort of said this to entrepreneurs, you know, I've got an FD that works for me. I've got an accountant in the house right now in our business. That means that they're really on the management. They've really dotting the I's, crossing the T's. And then they've got the entrepreneur in it, that's me in our business, that's really pushing the business. And he's really making sure that the management happens. Lack of management is another reason why businesses fail. And it's the biggest mistake that business owners make, is that they are way too entrepreneurially heavy and they don't have good quality management in the business. It's a smart thing. Management is one of the biggest mistakes, or lack of management, that business owners make. Point number three, and the biggest mistake that business owners make is this: low value tasks. The business owner is doing the low value operational tasks of the business rather than building the business. Most business owners run their business rather than build a business. And this is critical. See, the business owner should be on marketing, getting customers, keeping customers, growing sales, making deals happen. If they force themselves into low value tasks, disastrous. Quick little story, and it's going to be a 20-second story. Is this. I was working with one of my clients. They've got a multi-million pound business. And the business owner said to me one day, I said, oh, I've been really busy today. I said, oh, what have you been doing? I've been on the forklift sorting the warehouse out. The warehouse looks fantastic now. I got really cross with him because he was doing a low value task. That is not a task that's going to increase the size of the business. He could have got someone in to do that. So if you're doing low value tasks, that's a big mistake. You're not going to grow your business, and dangerous times could happen for you. Point four in the biggest mistakes that business owners make is this one: lack of focus. See, So many entrepreneurs are attracted to so many different opportunities that they don't follow one course until successful. Follow one course until successful. That's the best way to think about focus. If you're riding many different horses in your business, you're never going to get one over the finish line. Get something over the finish line before you start another one. And if you are riding eight different horses, make sure you've got eight different jockeys that can focus on their horse. That's eight different managers. This is the big thing that entrepreneurs, they do some simple successful stuff. They start getting success. They think they're a superhero and they can manage tons and tons of different businesses. No. You need to make sure you've got good quality management for all the different branches of your entrepreneurial mind. And if you haven't got the great management, follow one course until successful. Point five in the biggest mistakes that business owners make is they build a business with no margin. If you've got no or little or low margin, it's going to be very difficult for you to protect yourself against all the rising costs of business. When you think about a company like Disney that has super high margin in their business, they can continually reinvest in their business. They continually look after customers, give them what I call customer cuddles, because there's enough margin in the business. They can give their customers stuff for free. You know, if you've got a complaint at Disney, they just give you your money back, or they'll give you something in return, and customers love that. But it's because they've got margin in the stuff that they sell, they can really look after you. If you become what I call a P&L thinking business, a profit and loss thinking business, where you're really looking at the costs really tightly, you can't do any of that stuff because you need huge scale to be profitable. Why do you want huge scale to be profitable? Think about a lower turnover with a higher margin, and you're going to survive a lot longer. Number six in the biggest mistakes that business owners make is no follow-up with customers. This is a real crucial one. So if someone sends in a query for you, you follow up and you say, yeah, this is the price, blah, 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 and then you just leave it. The smart business owner does more than that. They make three or four calls, or they'll send a letter in the post, they'll send a brochure in the post, they follow up with an email, they follow up with a text message. Text message follow-up is a great way of getting people to do what you want them to do. Here's a little thing for you. Emails have got a 10% open rate. Text messages have got an 80% open rate. I always tell this to my staff. I go, oh, you know, if you're following up with someone, don't forget to send them an email and a text message. You've got a far better chance of getting someone to respond back to you. Leave a message on a voicemail. Don't just think about this bloody digital world we're living in. It's okay to still send stuff through the post. It's okay to send a text message and pick up the old dog and bone. It still really works. Lack of follow-up is a big reason why businesses don't get where they want to get to. And this is not just customers. This is about getting great people to come and work for your business. This is about getting great joint venture partners or funding. Make sure you follow up all the time. Successful people are great at follow-up. Most people are not doing it enough. Let's click on to point seven. And last but not least, the big one here is knowing your numbers. Make sure you're producing a monthly profit and loss. Most businesses rely on an annual set of accounts, disastrous, or a quarterly set of accounts, disastrous. You need to have great management information, a monthly profit and loss on a monthly basis at the very minimum. This monthly profit and loss is what I call a naked set of accounts. It's not done for tax reasons. It's given to you so that you can really see in a naked position how well the business is doing that month, so that you can plan for the future month and react much quicker. Also, here's the things that you want to know. You want to know your average customer value. This is very important. How much is your average customer value spent per head per customer? You also want to know a monthly profit and loss. And the big third one, this is my three KPIs here, is you want to know your labor to turnover ratio. So if you're working in leisure, it's about 30% of your turnover will go on staffing. If you've got daycare or care homes, it's 50%. If you're in retail, it's 13%. Find out whatever it is for your industry and make sure that you benchmark against that so that you're always keeping your labor to turnover ratio in check. Don't forget, guys, the biggest overhead in most businesses walks on two legs, so you want to be keeping an eye on it. Thanks for watching. If you've got anything you want some, you know, just give some clarification, hit them in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel, click the notification bell, and I will do my very best to respond to all your comments and give clarification. And if you want to see me live, I run seminars all over the UK and in my own businesses. In the video description, there's a link on how you can book on, and I will see you live at my business growth seminar for free to help grow your business. See you very soon. Bye-bye.